Hello friends, welcome to Engineering Funda family. In this video, I'll explain you types of dipole antennas. Based on size of dipole antenna, one can classify dipole antennas into three categories. See, smallest size of dipole belongs to Hertzian dipole. Size of Hertzian dipole antenna is lower than lambda by 50. After that, second category is small dipole antenna. Size of small dipole is there in between lambda by 10 to lambda by 50. And third category is basic dipole antenna. Basic dipole antenna size is of lambda by 2. So basically, based on size, we have three different types of dipoles: Hertzian dipole, small dipole, and basic dipole. In this video, I'll explain these three categories in great clarity. Let me start explanation with first category, that is Hertzian dipole. See, Hertzian dipole is shortest form of dipole, means size of Hertzian dipole is very small. Size of Hertzian dipole, that is lower than lambda by 50. First of all, one should know, in dipole there are two poles. You can observe here with generator, this is first pole and this is second pole. In total, size of dipole over here is lower than lambda by 50 with Hertzian dipole. See, Hertzian dipole is having minimum applications. The reason is, with Hertzian dipole, there are few issues. See, it is having lower radiation efficiency. Hertzian dipole antenna is having minimum radiation efficiency in dipole antenna category, that one can say. The reason is, Hertzian dipole antenna is having lower radiation resistance. Here with Hertzian dipole, we have higher losses and it has larger region of reactive field. See, with any antenna, we have three different categories of radiation regions. Let me show you how. See, here we have three categories of radiation regions. Nearest one is near field reactive region. So closer to antenna, we have near field reactive region. After that, we have near field radiative region. And farthest one is far field region. So here with antenna, we have three regions, right? Nearest to the antenna is near field reactive region, and here you will be observing, with this near field reactive region, we don't have electromagnetic waves. See, electromagnetic waves are there with far field region only, right? And in far field region only, you will be observing propagation of electromagnetic waves, right? So here, near field reactive region, that is unwanted region, that one can say. The reason is, in near field reactive region, maximum inductive components are there. And as if we have maximum inductive components, then there will be maximum coupling with other RF circuits as well. So here with Hertzian dipole antenna, this near field reactive region, that is having larger size over here. And as it is having larger size over here, it produces higher losses. Even this Hertzian dipole, that is having lower radiation resistance, because of which it is having lower radiation efficiency. And because of all these issues, Hertzian dipole antenna, that is having minimum applications in dipole antenna categories. Right. Now I'll explain you second category of dipole, that is small dipole. Small dipole antenna size is there in between lambda by 10 to lambda by 50. So small dipole antenna, that is bit bigger compared to Hertzian dipole. It is having size which is there in between lambda by 10 to lambda by 50. See, small dipole antenna, that is having few applications. Like, one can use it in narrow band applications. Usually we use small dipole antenna in tuner circuits, and small dipole antenna, that is effective with low frequency applications. So for low frequency applications, usually we use small dipole antenna. Let me take one example. Like as if I say we have frequency F that is of 10 megahertz. So with 10 megahertz, what is the wavelength? Wavelength is C by F. C is 3 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second divided by F is 10 megahertz means 10 to the power 7. So here we will be having 30 meter of wavelength, right? We will be having 30 meter of wavelength. See, if wavelength is 30 meter and if you consider antenna size is lambda by 2, then dipole will be having size of 15 meter, right? So that is quite large. But if you have small dipole over here, like as if I consider length is in between lambda by 10 to lambda by 50, let us assume L is lambda by 30 over here. So in that situation, 30 divided by 30 means 1 meter size of small dipole that we need to have for frequency of 10 megahertz, right? So for lower frequencies, one can use small dipole antenna, right? And for higher frequencies, one can use normal dipole antenna. See, small dipole antenna that is having narrowband applications. Usually we use it in tuner circuits as well as it is effective with low frequency applications. Here with small dipole antenna, we have some issues. Like it is having lower radiation efficiency. The reason is it is having lower radiation resistance. In future coming videos, I'll be going to derive radiation resistance of small dipole, Hertzian dipole and normal dipole. At that time, you will get to know that this small dipole is having lower radiation efficiency because of lower radiation resistance. See, it is also having higher losses and it has larger region of reactive field. I have already told you, see, there are three categories of region: near field reactive, near field radiative and far field region. In near field reactive region, we don't have EM waves. So this is useless region that one can say in terms of communication with the use of antenna. So here, see, this small dipole antenna that is having larger reactive field region over here, right? And that is having higher inductive components, which will be producing coupling with some other RF circuits as well, right? Now I'll explain you third category, that is basic dipole antenna that is having size of lambda by 2. This is widely used in many applications. Like we use it in Yagi Uda antenna, we use it in tower antenna, we use it in dipole arrays, right? There are many applications with dipole antenna. See, it is having higher radiation efficiency because of it is having higher radiation resistance. With dipole of size of lambda by 2, we have radiation resistance of 73 ohm, because of which we have higher radiation efficiency, right? See, it is having minimum losses in dipole antenna categories and it has minimum region of reactive field in the dipole antenna categories, because of which this basic dipole with size of lambda by 2 is widely used in many applications. So basically we have three categories of dipole antennas. See, we have Hertzian dipole, small dipole and basic dipole. Hertzian dipole antenna, that is smallest form of dipole antenna. It is having very rare applications, right? Small dipole antenna, that is having few applications, which is there with respect to lower frequency applications, as well as we use it in tuner circuits. While majority of dipole antennas are used with basic dipole with size of lambda by 2. The reason is it is having highest radiation efficiency. It is having radiation resistance of 73 ohm, because of which it is having higher radiation efficiency compared to other dipole categories. That is how different categories of dipole antennas are there. I hope you have understood this. Still, if anything that you would like to share, then note it down in comment section. I'll be happy to help you. Thank you so much for watching this video.